Go.
Okay, guys, so the Serbian cuisine again. Sorry, it's not vibrators music playing in the background, it's actually chill jazz, because there is somebody else living here that likes more quiet of a music, you know? And it's a good setting. So today, Gibanica. Gibanica is a cheese phyllo pastry pie, the way my mom taught me a long time ago. Again, with North American ingredients that you can find, which are unfortunately not organic like they are in Serbia, but we'll deal with what we have. It's still gonna be yummy. I'm gonna show you how to do it. It's really simple, it's quick. We are preheating the oven already to 400 degrees, middle rack. Okay, it's all gonna go in here. So, ingredients, 500 grams ricotta cheese, 500 grams cottage cheese, 6 whole eggs, 250 grams feta, about 100 grams of sour cream. All goes in here, and we're gonna beat it all down. So salt is going to be to the taste, so let's do this. So number one and two. Just watch for the shell not to drop in. Not a good feeling once you have everything done and something crunchy and annoying in your mouth, not good. All right. All right. So, something missing, of course, but anyway. All right, so now salt to your taste, right? Remember, feta is salty already, but there is not too much of it. Ricotta is kind of sweet, cottage is the same thing. So I do three big pinches.
Yeah,
two, three. I think that should be enough. Now first we need to beat this down, right? So let's do this real quick. I don't want to make 1 hour video here. That's not the goal. But this is really simple recipe, easy to do. It's very traditional. It's the first thing you're gonna try if you ever travel to Serbia. Every household is proud of making their own good Gibanica phyllo pastry cheese pie. Gonna add the cheeses. Okay, this we need to mix first. So I'll give it a good mix. Yeah, quick, nothing too crazy. Now once we do this, we'll need to kind of crumble it, so you can do it with your hands too. We need decent chunks inside. So once the pie is done, when you bite it, it's gonna feel really, really good. So just do it like this. It's a big piece here, I'm gonna dig in. Still do it, who cares, it's all nice. Yummy, it's finger licking good.
The whiskers also break.
Yes, I agree with you. Okay, and then you're gonna add some. I did 14% sour cream, so it's really thick. Because you know, the sour cream, when you cook it or whatever you do with it, releases a little bit of water. This is not the goal here. So we're gonna come back. So, okay, we are back. So everything is mixed here, right? I have a little bit of cooking oil, and then we have the phyllo pastry sheets here, right? So first we're gonna oil the baking pan. Not too much. Oil the sides too, really good. Now this is really simple to do. We're gonna start with a double sheet on the bottom, right? So, and if you're in a local store that has this, I don't recommend those from chain stores. There should be a local store from my region, from the Balkans, selling phyllo pastry sheets. So do the thicker ones. Thicker ones are for the salty type of pies, right? Thinner sheets, they're for desserts. That's how we do them back home. So we do this real quick, then another one comes in, right? I'm gonna do it this way, so to cover the bottom as good as I can. And this doesn't have to be perfect, because once the fill sets in and it bakes, it won't make too big of a difference. A little bit of oil again, just dab, dab, dab. That's all you need to do. Try to touch as much of the sheet as you can. Like this. Now we're gonna do, add the fill. All right. So we're gonna go like this, number one, and we're gonna try number two. I'm normally liberal with this, although if you put too much, then it's too heavy, it takes a little bit longer to bake. But regardless, the end result is gonna be yummy. A little bit more. So again, everything by the eye. Don't put too much, don't put not enough, and life's gonna be good. Now, mom's trick is a little bit of carbonated water. Again, you need to sprinkle just a little bit, oops, out of control, on top of every layer. And we keep on going. Go like this. Just stuff it in.
Very roughly, right? To lay the very rough.
Yes, that's right. It doesn't have to be perfect. Where we're looking to be really nice is the top. So once we do the top, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be a nice cover. Now this is smaller baking pan, so maybe we won't use all the fill for the pie. But it's fine. You could always get another 500 grams of phyllo pastry sheets and use the same mix again. And again, guys, if you feel like you should add spinach or something else that you like inside, yes, you can. And it's gonna be just as yummy. Greeks do it. They have that spinach pies. Spinaco pita, I think they call it, and it's fantastic. Same thing like this, just a little bit different. From region to region, there is variations, but they're all good. Okay, we're gonna keep layering this thing, and then once we are done, I'll show you the finish. We'll be right back.
Go.
Okay, guys, so we are back. We are almost done here. Again, a little bit of oil in between the layers. Dab, 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 not too much oil. If you like it a little bit greasier, okay, fine, you can do it, but we don't. So we don't do it that way. So we're gonna fill in the last layer here and then close it up and put it to bake. Again, this one is really loaded with nice cheese fill. All right. That would be it. Now we need to close. Brief explanation why carbonated water. It's for the baking part, right? So as it bakes, it's gonna rise quite a bit, you know, so carbonated water helps it rise and helps the heat go to everything better. So the end result is really yummy. Okay, so let's close this. I'm gonna do one like that. Tuck it in nicely. Don't decide to go with the fingers in. No problem there. Like this. I'm gonna add again a little bit more oil depth on the sheet. We don't want to dry my pastry sheet, so okay, there's the last one coming. Again, they break apart easily, you know, as soon as you take it out, so don't worry about that part. No big deal. It will all bake and be yummy. Right? I'm gonna close it like this. Spread it a little bit more to fill everything up. This. We're gonna oil it up again. All right. This is going good. One extra sheet here out of 500 grams that I don't want to throw away. So we're gonna tuck this in, so it's gonna be nice. Again, I need to press a little bit so it expands back again. It doesn't have to be perfect, you could simply wrinkle everything in. Dab in a cheese fill and just put in a pan. Bake and enjoy. All right. So in the oven it goes a little bit more carbonated water on top, and that's it. Okay, we'll put it in the oven and come back once it's baked.
How many degrees?
450.
450, okay.
Again, no timer. In our case, we just simply wash it every 10 minutes till it's nice,
golden brown,
nice crust is formed, and then we take it out, but that's coming up. Okay, so 70 minutes after it's ready. Again, it's our oven 450 degrees. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna sprinkle a little bit of just normal water on top. Just like this. All right. So cover it to steam it up a little bit, and then we'll be coming back in a few minutes to cut it up. All right, so all baked, all cut up. That's how it looks after it settles down a little bit. So I'm gonna take one and put it on a plate. Make one cut here for you. And that's how it looks. There we go. Enjoy. Try and make it, put comments down there, let me know how it went, any questions, let us know, make sure you like, subscribe, notifications, share. You don't cook? Enjoy. Thank you.